live from the Dunkin' Latte Lounge.
Well, what's up? I'm Brady from Z100. Welcome to the virtual Dunkin' Latte Lounge. Yo, we appreciate you watching while you're probably supposed to be working from home, but you're on YouTube instead. So, hey, that's how working from home works, right? But today we have a really, really dope artist. And he's not just an artist. He does everything, man. He's a director. He is a screenwriter. He's a producer. Please welcome Ryan Lamar. Dude, what's up, man?
What's good, man? I need to get you to introduce me more.
Yeah, you know what? I'll be your hype guy.
There we go, man.
Moving forward. Cool. I could use a side hustle. Yeah, that's right. Dude, I wish we could be seeing you in person, but, you know, 2020.
Soon, man. Yeah. I'm in Chicago. So,
okay.
Y'all in New York, right?
Yeah, we're in New York. But where are you at right now? It looks like you're in, like, a recording studio.
I'm at our studio, Palace State Studio in Chicago, Illinois, man. Yeah, we try to do a little bit of something, give a little bit of people a little bit of that live feel. So
that's right, dude. That's what we need in 2020.
Yeah,
you know, even if it's just a video, it still feels good. You know, it's better than where I'm at right now. I'm in my apartment at my kitchen table, and it's weird because like I've never had to clean my apartment before interviewing somebody. But like with this stuff, that's just how we're. Well, by clean, I mean I literally just shoved everything to the side over here.
Gotcha.
But you know, that's just how it goes. But let's kind of get to it. So for those like who are just kind of discovering you, maybe this is the first time they've heard of you watching this video. Give us like a little background on who you are, because like, yo, your story is so like, it's very inspirational, you know, just to hear like where you came from and where you are now. So,
man, well, look, man, to keep it real, you know, God has been amazing in my life. I feel like I'm on my second chance at getting things right. You know, my name is Ryan Lamar. I'm an artist. I'm a filmmaker. I'm a storyteller. I'm a content creator. And, you know, just blessed to be able to utilize the gifts and the talents that I have to inspire people in this time that we're going through in this country right now and in the world right now. And, you know, I've just been blessed to be able to embrace platforms like yours to tell my message of being a sinner that was saved by grace in an amazing way. So thank y'all for having me. Thank you, bro, for bringing me on here.
For sure, man. For sure. And that's the one thing, too, is like, especially with your album and the movie Canal Street that you did. You know, there's like a lot of I feel like the message is like hope and perseverance. You know what I mean? Like, it's just a lot of like, keep going, keep pushing forward, keep fighting, you know, and that's literally everything that's going on in 2020. You know, it's just to keep fighting and keep, you know, keep going for it, you know, and hopefully, you know, that'll lead to amazing things. And that's just kind of like, that's kind of the message that I kind of get with a lot of your stuff.
Yeah. Yeah. No, it's definitely what it is, man. It's about transparency and honesty too, you know?
Yes.
You can't really find a breakthrough if you're not honest with yourself and honest with the people around you. So even with our album, you know, and I say our album because we have an amazing team. You'll see some of them today. Jack Red is one of them. My G is another one. But we just wanted to highlight the mess. And, you know, within the mess is perfection. That's what the album is called, A Perfect Mess. I almost feel like my life's been a perfect mess, but I'm on the other side, you know, and talking to y'all, so I must be doing something right.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah, it's working. And dude, actually, I was just kind of looking up, you know, stuff about you, and you, so you went from, you were homeless in Chicago, correct?
No, I was homeless in LA, actually.
Oh, in LA, okay. And you, you lived in a U-Haul truck.
Yes.
You know?
Start sponsoring me for how much I'll be talking about that.
Hey, there we go. There we go.
listen, not going to sugarcoat it. I was hanging around with the wrong folks and found myself in a downward spiral, and I found myself living on the streets of Van Nuys. And, you know, when you're below rock bottom, you know, you really have to, like, you have nothing. You have no, and you're not blaming nobody else but yourself. You know, I had to really, really get my life back together, man. And, you know, but I don't regret it because it's enabled me to share my testimony on platforms like this. You don't have to go that far. You know what I mean? You don't have to wake up in a U-Haul van to get your life together. You know, you could just bump your head and be like, okay, I probably shouldn't do that again.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Right. But yeah, I was homeless for about 2 years on the streets of Van Nuys, living in a U-Haul van. And then it's like God just turned the light back on. And literally got out the van. 6 months later, I was working on my first film, Restore Me. year and a half later, I was filming Canal Street, you know, and while I was filming Canal Street, we're working on A Perfect Mess, you know, and now I'm working on some more films. So I just feel like I've been on a roller coaster, man.
Yeah. Yeah. That's such a, that's just like such a testament though, to who you are and like what you, you know, what you've brought to the table and what you were able to really provide for yourself, you know, going from that to this, I mean, that is, that that's insane. And, yeah. And so awesome, you know? Yeah. And especially just like everything that you've kind of worked on, you know, you've done for yourself and, you know, and you were able to, you know, you, with Canal Street and, you know, you're able to create that and really tell that story. And now you got this new album, which by the way, the new album is it for me. So it's Perfect Mess and it's an album, but it's almost like a, it's like a storyline. Like it's a big, it's like a big, almost like an audiobook in a way,
yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And it kind of tells, I would assume, you know, it's your story.
Yes, sir.
Yep.
It's my story, man. You know, being a storyteller, being a filmmaker and being an artist, like, you know, I get to just kind of put it all together, you know, from the album to the interlude you're listening to. I mean, look, I grew up in the 90s, you know, on, you know, projects that had interludes and skits and all that stuff. And so,
yeah.
You know, it's not guaranteed that you'll ever be able to do another album or do another movie. So you got to put your all into it. So I just put my all into it, you know, and yeah, it's 20 tracks, but it's not 20 tracks of music. It's 20 tracks of just storytelling, music and all everything, man. We just have fun with it. You know, we didn't limit ourselves to, oh, this song's got to be 3 minutes and 47 seconds or it's got to be 2 minutes. Or this. We just went in the lab, have fun and made some music. And I feel like that's when you put your best foot forward, when you're not in any box per se, you're just creating. And then when we were done creating, man, we pressed pause and we mastered it and released it, man. And so it's been blessing people, man. So we're grateful for that.
That's awesome. I mean, when people listen to the album, you know, what do you want them to feel? What do you want them to think about when they're, you know, when they're listening to it and then they finished it? They're like, well, you know, what's like, what do you want their headspace to be?
I wanted to drive their faith to go out and do something, you know? You hear a lot of times like faith-based, you know, but like what drives your faith? What drives you to wake up in the morning? You know, I wanted to inspire people to be better than me. You know, you always want to inspire the people that are going to create better work than you, you know, because inspiration is contagious. Inspiring people to do better is contagious. Just like inspiring people to do worse is contagious, you know? Yeah. So at the end of the album, I want people to get up and go and do something, even if it's in front of your own computer, because you got to stay safe during these times. But, you know, to go do something, you right. know, don't wait. Don't wait till you're in a van to be inspired to get up, get out, and go get something.
Totally, totally. And if you do go out and do something, wear a mask.
Mask, gloves.
Mask it.
All of the nine. Yeah, six.
Got to mask it. When you first came on, you had your mask on.
Yeah.
And I was like, all right, cool. He's being safe.
Yep. Everybody in here today, we checked the temperature, like the whole nine.
There we go. Yeah, it's crazy just to see like what this world's going through and like it's good to have this type of album out during a time like this yes. for everything that's going on in 2020, because we need that comfort and that drive to, you know, kind of just like, yo, keep going, you know. Absolutely. So it's nice to have that. Yeah. So for sure. Well, yo, how about we hear some songs off the album?
Absolutely.
Like your band ready back there? Everybody ready?
Oh, they're ready, man. They're okay. Ready. Man. We excited.
All right.
Listen, we've been wanting to do this since quarantine started. So
very yeah. Cool. Yo, let's hear some stuff.
So the song Distance, it's a funny story. Well, it's funny now. So I'm in the hospital, had an emergency surgery, and I just got out and I'm coming to out of twilight phase, and I hit up Jabari and I'm like, hey, I think we need another song on the record. And in my head, you know, this is during COVID. This is, you know, I'm away from my girl at the time. And I'm like, you know, we should make something for the quarantine, married folks, trying to do it right under the roof. I mean, what else do you do during COVID when you lock down for 4 or 5 months, right? So, and Jack Red, Jabari is such an amazing, talented musician, and we were missing him on the record. So I said, well, this is a perfect thing, because I had kind of been thinking about it anyway. And so I kind of just gave him the record to just do whatever he wanted to do on it, and Distance came from it. And while we're social distancing in America and in the country, and we're also distancing ourselves from our loved ones, I always want to make sure people don't distance themselves from God. So this is what the song is. I hope you like it. I hope it blesses you, and I hope it makes you reach out to that special someone. Just trying to bring some to the Virtual Dunkin' Latte Lounge. Let's go, let's go.
I'll do what it takes, what do you say? Don't worry, I'm willing to wait. I'll show you the way, it's okay. Been needing you more every day, so don't be afraid. Let's raise the stakes, and let's try to get out our own way. I'll call your face, ain't gotta raise. But first thing, let's clear up the space. Got my undivided, hearts collided, I'm decided. So excited, open-minded, God provided. Soul searching, close my eyes and pray, got it. It was written, what he bridges, there ain't no dividing. Oh, lately, I've been dealing with some distance, searching for the thing that's missing. Can't believe that I made it this far, this long apart. Been needing you right from the start. Oh, it's far from perfect. Oh, this love's a circus, and it's crazy, it ain't easy, but it's worth it. I'll do what it takes, what do you say? Don't worry, I'm willing to wait, I'll show you the way, it's okay. Needing you more every day, so don't be afraid, let's raise the stakes, and let's try to get out.
I think about you all the time. I travel all around the world, but I'm better when I'm with you all by my side. Girl, can we go the distance? Yeah, girl, going on a mission. Now the new I say I need to raise the stakes. Girl, I promise I'll make your heart break. Baby girl, just listen, cause the world's dealing with some issue. Baby, we can just chill, don't need to count. We can just go slow. We can just go slow.
Said it's far from perfect. Yeah, this love's a circus. And it's crazy, it ain't easy. But it's worth every bit of it. I'll do what it takes. What do you say? Don't worry, I'm willing to wait. I'll show you the way. It's okay. Needing you more every day. So don't be afraid. Let's raise the stakes. And let's try to get out our own way. I'll call your face. Ain't gotta raise. First thing, let's clear up the space. Get rid of the distance.
So they say a man who finds a wife finds a good thing.
Get rid of the distance.
So this goes out to all the quarantine married folks doing it right under the roof. That's what I'm trying to say.
Get rid of the distance.
Red Gorilla Music. Ryan Lamar. So I Ain't Going Back, man, is a very personal record to me. During my time being homeless back in 2010, you know, and living in that U-Haul van, and man, I hit beyond rock bottom. I had a lot of time to reevaluate my life. I had a lot of time to open up my book and just write. And I Ain't Going Back is not only a love song to, you know, all the women that I did wrong, all the mistakes that I made, all the issues that I had, but I Ain't Going Back is a love letter to God to let him know that I'm not going back to my old ways. I'm not going back to the man, to the old man I used to be, but I'm moving forward with the grace of God. I'm moving forward in my life. I'm moving forward with just moving into the place and the position that he has me in. And that's what I Ain't Going Back is about. It's a positive anthem for not only black men, but just men in general, to get over your crap, move forward in your life, and treat the women in your life right. Because he who finds a wife finds a good thing. So this is I Ain't Going Back.
I ain't going back,
nah.
I ain't going back no more,
uh-huh.
Back no more. I ain't going back,
nah.
I ain't going back no more,
yeah.
Back no more. I've been through all that,
hard
that. Been through all that before, that and more. And I ain't going back, I ain't going back no more, back no. I ain't going back, I ain't going back no more,
I ain't
back,
back
no more. I ain't going back,
uh-huh.
I ain't going back no more,
I ain't back,
back no more. I've been through all that,
yeah.
Been through all that before, that and more. I ain't going back,
yeah.
Go. I ain't going back no
yeah.
More, back
yeah.
No.
When I first started, I was all bad. I was in LA every day, down my honey. Every day a different chip, no, don't get me started. I tried that nothing once or twice, left me brokenhearted. Now I'm a Chi-Town native, my guy. So all that Hollywood glitz set me faded, my guy. And it's hard to find that right girl when you running through the streets like a hot boy. I had to change so many things up in my life, like looking for the happiness at night. Divine told me when you find her, man, you really wait.
Really
I'm like, really wait. He like, dog, get really wait.
Like, really wait.
The beef off from that wedding ring, like, really far.
Really
all
far.
I see is all smiles when she see Lamar. I mean, I change all of my ways and I pray for her. And I ain't going back, I'm finna marry her. Yeah,
let's get it. I ain't going back.
Nah.
I ain't going back no more.
Yeah.
Back no more. I ain't going back.
Yeah.
Look, I ain't going back no more.
Let's go.
Back
let's
no
go.
More. I've been through yeah. all that. Been through all that before.
Let's go.
That
let's go.
More. And I ain't going back.
I ain't going back.
I ain't going back no more.
Back
no.
Back. So The Remedy is a very special song to me. You know, when I was on the street of Van Nuys and it was just me and God and my notebook, I started penning ideas and started penning where I wanted to be. And before I knew it, like, the Lord became my best friend. The Lord brought me to reveal the issues that I was facing in my life. And the things that I had put myself in, let me tell you something. When you burn bridges and you get a second chance at getting things right, the remedy in my life was God. The remedy in my life was Jesus Christ. And that's what The Remedy is about. As everything is going on in the world today, we have to find that one true remedy, that one true God in our life, and that passion and the inspiration. And that's what The Remedy is about. So I hope this song blesses you. I hope it lifts your spirits. And above all, it lifts your head up to God in these trying times. God bless you.
Finding myself where I don't belong.
Yeah.
I grew up, I screwed up, then moved up. I never even knew about your grace, and it was almost up. The pedal I was placed on was too much. See the crown on my head, it was too rough. You took everything from me when I blew up. You took my friends and my money. Everything I built, man, you stripped away from me. See, I was standing on that street corner. We hit the blinker on a 405. Cause we was on Sepulveda, yeah, in the mix. Headed to a party, man, about to get a fix. How could I leave a life like this? If you can rock my wrongs like this? How could I even trust what I hadn't seen? How could I become what I couldn't believe? I'm sitting here stressing. Come on. What do you
want from me?
I'm only
ordinary.
How could I
ever be
more than that?
Yeah,
come on. Trying to find my
way,
yeah, forever.
Struggling.
But whatever you want
from me,
I know you're the remedy.
Come on, had it, come on, mess. You came to me when I was battling more than sex. How could you want me to lead? I'm a peon. You should have took me, you took Leon. I burned so many bridges, I can't build them back. Now I'm a liar, I'm a cheater, all facts. So I got knives in my back from some old friend. Since fourth grade, we was all in. No longer friend of me now, cause we some grown men. Watch your suckle letter, homie, this the lion in.
And afflicted.
Yeah,
going through something right now. I know it's been tough. The world feels like it's caving in.
I know you're the remedy. I know you're the remedy.
Oh God, there's one true love.
I know you're the remedy.
And there's one true remedy. Everything that you're going through right now, just find it inside of you to lift your head up high and keep praising. Come on. Yeah. Praising. They say the last days is here, though. You know what I'm saying? So you better get yourself right.
No more.
We'd like to thank y'all for tuning in. Virtual Dunkin' Latte Lounge.
I bet they don't do it, yeah, like this.
Red Gorilla Music. Jack Red. Ryan Lamar.
What's good, y'all? This is Ryan Lamar. I'm here with my guy, Jack Red. I want to send a special shout out to the virtual Dunkin' Latte Lounge. Thank y'all for having us today, man. Say something to the people, bro.
Hey, man, we appreciate y'all for letting us on this platform. It's a huge message, and what better way to put a huge message than on a huge platform? So we appreciate y'all.
God bless y'all, and keep God first.
Yo, give it up for Ryan Lamar, even though we're the only two on this call right now. But hey, give it up. Dude, very cool. Very, very cool. Thank you for taking the time to chat with us and perform too. It was really cool talking to you and really just kind of hearing your message. And I honestly think you should also add inspirational speaker to your repertoire of things.
I told you, man, you need to introduce me.
Yeah, you know, I will do that. You know what? If I can get on a payroll or something, I'm about it.
I'll have my people call your people. How about that?
Okay. Good. Very cool. What's up, by the way? What are your handles, just so people want to connect with you and follow you?
You can follow me at on Instagram and Facebook at Ryan Lamarr. That's RHYANLAMARR. And you can follow me on Twitter at Lamarr Ryan. And if you were inspired by today's performances, if you like them, man, look, go and download the album right now. And keep your head up. Stay inspired. Stay encouraged. And keep pushing.
Love it, man. Thank you so much. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Live from the Dunkin' Latte Lounge.